There are 5 stages associated with Alzheimer's disease: preclinical Alzheimer's disease, mild cognitive impairment, mild dementia, moderate Alzheimer's disease, and severe Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease begins long before any symptoms become apparent. This stage is called preclinical Alzheimer's disease, and it's usually identified only in research settings. You won't notice symptoms during this stage, nor will those around you. This stage of Alzheimer's can last for years, possibly even decades. My research is focused on this stage. The ultimate goal is to predict who will develop Alzheimer's before the symptoms appear, because the moment people develop symptoms, millions of brain cells have already died. What's gone is gone. We will never be able to repair brain cells or regain lost functions. But we may be able to prevent brain cells from dying in the first place. Mild cognitive impairment is an intermediate state between the everyday forgetfulness that occurs with age and the more pronounced memory deficits in Alzheimer's. As the name suggests, it causes mild cognitive changes that are serious enough to be noticed, but do not affect the individual's ability to carry out everyday activities. It may take 2 to 5 years for mild cognitive impairment to progress to Alzheimer's disease. The next stage is mild dementia. Patients with mild dementia can usually drive, work, and socialize. However, they may have memory lapses, like forgetting familiar words or the location of everyday objects. They misplace things more frequently and become easily confused. They may also experience a loss of interest in activities they once enjoyed and changes in their mood. Alzheimer's disease is often diagnosed in this stage because it becomes clear that a person is having significant trouble with their memory. Other people may also start to notice that something seems off. At this point, however, most can still function independently and will try to compensate for their declining memory. I once had a patient working a demanding job that required him to use multiple sources of information, the internet, articles, and books, to understand the problem and figure out the appropriate solution. At some point, he found himself looking back and forth from one source to another, trying to hold the information from one article in his head long enough to compare it with what he saw on the computer. He ultimately got to the point where he simply couldn't do it. And that's when he came to the hospital and was diagnosed with dementia. During the moderate dementia stage, people become more forgetful and confused and need more help with daily activities and self-care. People with moderate dementia may wander in search of surroundings that feel more familiar. It's also not unusual for people to develop unfounded suspicions. For example, to become convinced that friends, family, or professional caregivers are stealing from them, or that a spouse is having an affair. Individuals often grow restless, especially late in the day, and some may even have aggressive physical outbursts. A patient of mine told me he'd wake up in the middle of the night, jump out of bed, threaten his wife, and throw things at her, simply because he didn't remember she was his wife. In the final stage of the illness, the decline of physical functioning begins to parallel the decline in cognitive functioning. Use this simple formula for recognizing end-stage dementia. Can't walk, can't talk, can't eat. They lose their ability to communicate. Muscles become rigid, reflexes abnormal, and eventually, they lose the ability to swallow and control bladder and bowel functions. The patient, by now, requires total assistance with eating, dressing, using the bathroom, and all other daily self-care tasks. They have a weaker immune system and therefore have a high risk of getting infections like pneumonia, a common cause of death in individuals with dementia. On average, people with Alzheimer's disease live between 8 and 12 years after diagnosis, but some survive 20 years or more. Thank you for watching this video. Please watch my next video if you would like to know how we hope to detect dementia 10 years before the start of the first symptoms.